sporting goods in the New York Life ACC tournament, live from the Greensboro Coliseum in Greensboro, North Carolina. About an hour drive from the University of North Carolina. The 19th ranked North Carolina Tar Heels, the number 5 seed in this tournament, taking on Louisville. Ranked 14th of the nation, the number 4 seed in this tournament. Louisville seeing its first action of the tournament today. The top 4 seeds had double byes to the quarterfinals. Roy Williams Tar Heels beat Boston College yesterday to get here. Roy is Marcus Page leading the way with the freshman Justin Jackson. Tokono Johnson and James, the front court, and for Louisville, without Chris Jones, thrown out of the program, Quentin Snyder starts at guard with their leading scorer, Terry Rozier, Wayne Blackshear, Chinando Onuwaku, and Montrezl Harrell, the star forward for Rick Pitino. Louisville dressed in white. Bryce Johnson won the tip for the Carolina Blue. Mike Eads, Tim Nestor, and Bill Covington working the game, and they're underway. Third meeting of the season. They played two classics in the regular season, each winning on their home court, but having to come from double figures down in the second half to do so. Marcus Page for three, and a great start for North Carolina.
That's a great sign for North Carolina. They need to make some outside shots to loosen up the tough Louisville zone defense.
Rozier, 17 points per game. They'll lead the way for Louisville. Montrezl Harrell, nifty running hook. And Louisville scores on its first possession.
Well, whoever wins the paint is probably going to win the game. And Louisville's won. They dominated the paint, especially on the offensive glass, in the win at Chapel Hill. Likewise for the Tar Heels. This game is going to be won in the trenches today.
Page faked another three. Bryce Johnson had it popped out to Montrezl Harrell. Averages 9.5 rebounds per game. Second in the conference behind Tanya Jakiri of Miami. Rozier, sophomore, and they'll say it is North Carolina ball as he couldn't connect with Montrezl Harrell near the bucket.
Well, the contrast of styles here, Sean. Carolina wants to play a fast, up-tempo game. They want this game in the 70s or 80s. Louisville wants a ball control game. They want the score in the 50s or 60s. Tempo will be key today to win this game.
Bryce Johnson inside again. The tip wouldn't go for James. Jackson was inside, had a crack at it. And Harrell said that's enough of that. Rozier, the pull-up, well off the mark. James, a nice job to tip it out. Leads to a break. Tokono off to Jackson. And the freshman makes it 5-2.
For as good as Louisville's been on the defensive end, they've been the ACC's worst team in transition defense, allowing almost 15 points per game in transition. They need great floor balance if they want to win this game.
Wayne Blackshear, the senior, having the best season of his career. He's bumped and out a chance to tie it at the free throw line as he was fouled by Bryce Johnson.
Well, here's a guy who's really tried to step his game up since the dismissal of Chris Jones. He's at his best when he is attacking, getting to the rack.
Blackshear from Chicago, averaging 10.7 points per game. He is their third leading scorer. Almost all of their scoring comes from Rozier at 17 a game, Harrell just under 16, Blackshear just under 11. The next highest scorer is Onuwaku with 3.5 points per game. Chance for a three-point play at the other end.
Well, nice drive by J.P. Tokono finding a bailout pass to Bryce Johnson. It was a nice job going to the rack, finishing against the imposing Montrezl Harrell.
First foul on Montrez. Johnson's free throw fell off. He's just 65% from the line. Louisville 24-7 for the season. They finished their first year in the ACC, 12-6 in conference play, good for the fourth seed. These two teams went right down to the last game of the regular season to determine the fourth and fifth seed. Harrell, soft touch and a drop. North Carolina lost to Duke the last game of the regular season to finish the conference 11-7. While Louisville beat Virginia at home, just the second loss of the year for the Cavaliers, to finish 12-6. And that was big because Louisville had the bye yesterday as a result of the fourth place finish. Carolina had to deal with Boston College. Rebounding foul and another against Louisville. It might be the second on Harrell based on his reaction. Nope, they give it to Blackshear. Juwana Waku. I'll take one other try with the other two guys, and we have them all covered. It is on Onowaku, his first. Page. And here's the game-winning shot in the final seconds when they rallied from 13 down to beat Louisville in Chapel Hill on January 10th. Johnson way off. Blackshear the rebound. Look out for Tokido. He was a little too frisky. Gets called for the bump. Here's Allison Williams.
Guys, Kennedy Meeks remains on the bench for North Carolina, but I have been told he will play today. He's been suffering from an illness that held him out of yesterday's game, but he's been medically cleared since he's no longer running at temperature. Roy Williams still wanted to watch him during warmups, which he did, and then we got a thumbs up afterwards. Now, Williams expressed some concern because he hasn't done anything with the basketball since Saturday, but he said it would be nice to have his best passing big man out there against this pressing Louisville team.
Nice move all the way to the bucket from Quentin Snyder. He moved into the starting lineup when they dismissed Chris Jones. They went 3-2 at the end of the regular season in games in which Jones didn't play. He had a one-game suspension. Since they threw him out for good, they're 3-1, including that big win against Virginia. And an electric Yum Center on Saturday. Tokido scores. And he did so right in the face of Mango Mathiang, who's come in off the bench. He was the hero of that win against Virginia, hit the game-winning shot in the final second.
Who knew? Who knew?
His only shot of the game. They won 59-57 over Virginia. Harrell stopped inside. James held his ground. It looked like Bryce Johnson deflected it. Tokido the pull-up from the free throw line. A rock. It came down to Mathiang, a 6'10 sophomore from Melbourne, Australia. Rozier fouled on a reach-in by Tokido. Timeout. On Marcus Page's shot in the closing second. 3 weeks later, Louisville from 18 down in the second half to win in overtime. Montrezl Harrell, oh, he was wide open on the offensive rebound. The third time it wouldn't go. Three misses by Harrell. The fourth wouldn't go. And Mathiang's fouled. Rozier even snuck in there and had a shot at one. Well, you have your rebounding stats this way.
Yeah, this is called the old Wes Unseld rule right here. Throwing up, going to get it. Love the battle, the fight, the stick-to-itiveness. Louisville Cardinals. You have two of the best offensive rebounding teams in the country. That's a strength for both of these teams. You're going to see a lot of that all day long.
Mathiang way off with the free throw. He's just 51%. Foul was on Justin Jackson. Joel Berry into the ball game now, playing guard for North Carolina, number two. Three times Mr. Basketball in Florida. Only person ever to do that. Page, three popped out. Long rebound and a race for it. The big fella, Joel James, got on the ground and winds up with Rozier. Underneath for Mathiang, the rim got in the way. Blackshear. And Jackson leads the heels back. Good transition defense that time by Louisville. Isaiah Hicks in for North Carolina, 22. Page. Joel James, the high arcing corner shot, rebounded by Harrell. Harrell has six rebounds already. As mentioned, padded by his difficulties around the rim. The Louisville turnover. And here comes Kennedy Meeks, who, as Allison said, hasn't seen any basketball-related activity since the Duke game on Saturday night. He's been very sick the last few days. They tested him twice for things like mono and strep throat. Couldn't find anything. He had a temperature of well over 100. He looked ready to go in the hallway before the game. Sometimes they have one player lead the dancing as they get fired up before they come down to the court. He was the man doing the dancing.
He was moving. He was moving well for big guy.
First touch, he's going right at it.
Well, it's imperative that Carolina continues to attack the paint against the Louisville zone. Louisville does a great job of being active in their zone, keeping the ball on the perimeter.
There's Meeks. Member of the five-man all-freshman team in the ACC this year.
The fouls were a huge theme of the game in Louisville. 33 fouls. Louisville shot 47 free throws.
Nice pass by Harrell, and Mathiang has the dunk. Mathiang averages 2.5 points per game. He's already surpassed his average with 4 today. Hicks, the best defensive player. Nice defense by Harrell to flick it away from Kennedy Meeks. Snyder to the bucket. And Louisville has a 6-point lead, nearly 7 minutes gone by.
One of the things Coach Williams brings up every time we talk to him is the turnovers. They must win the turnover game. It's been a bit of an issue, although they've been better down the stretch earlier in the year.
Nate Britt sends it inside. Meeks bumped, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Great interior big-to-big passing right there. Mathiang using his size advantage to his advantage. Great transition offense, running wide, running hard. Great finish by Quentin Snyder in the open court.
Kennedy Meeks, the free throw shooter, 12 points per game. And he's their second leading rebounder at 7.6. Just a fraction of the 8 rebounds a game from Bryce Johnson. It's the first game he's missed in his collegiate career. He's coming to the end of his sophomore season. He did not play yesterday against Boston College. With an 81-63 win yesterday over the Eagles for North Carolina. Rozier to the pull-up. Another one of the most improved players in the country. 7 points per game last year as a freshman, up to 17 this year as a sophomore.
And he's had to make the transition from the off-guard position to the point guard position with the dismissal of Chris Jones, and a great job at that.
Barry missed the scooping layup. Louisville by 7. And another team that sometimes can struggle to score. They've had a nice pace on their offense today. Rozier. They wave it off for an offensive foul on Terry Rozier. His first.
Nice vision by Isaiah Hicks, taking the contact, taking the punishment, getting the call.
I would be inclined to agree with Rick Pitino. Hicks, an outstanding defender. The coaches watch the tape and then name a defensive player of each game, and Hicks has won it 13 times this year for North Carolina. In their 32 games, they're 22-10, just 5-6 in their last 11. Out of bounds, last touch by Louisville's Anton Gill, who's in for Coach Pitino. A couple of Hall of Famers on these benches today, matching wits in Greensboro.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by New York Life and GMC.
That this tournament's been played in this venue, 62nd edition of the ACC tournament. Been a good building for North Carolina. They've won ACC titles in Greensboro in 67, which was the first time it was played here, 72, 75, 77, 79, 82, 97, and 1998. Seventeen ACC tournament titles all time for the Tar Heels. Only Duke's won more with 19. Louisville by 7. Small lineup on the floor. Page out there with Britt and Barry. Britt with the shot clock expiring, and a good rebound in traffic by Chinonu Onowuku, the freshman from Maryland, the brother of Arinze Onowuku, who's a fine player at Syracuse.
So far, Louisville winning the battle in the paint, outscoring Carolina 14-6.
move with the dribble. Got in trouble in the corner. Well guarded by Jackson Simmons, who's in off the bench. Britt brushed on the way up by Quentin Snyder. First foul on Snyder, the freshman, playing for his hometown university. He's from Louisville, Kentucky. So Nate Britt at the line. I mentioned yesterday, last year he shot every shot left-handed. This year the free throws are left-handed, and his shots from the floor are right-handed. He's had a good year.
He's an 80-plus shooter. I don't care what hand you shoot with. It's impressive.
39% from three, shooting right-handed. So,
athlete.
Gets them within five. 9 minutes gone by. Louisville playing at its first ACC tournament. As Seth Greenberg said on the pregame show, Rick Pitino's been great throughout his career in conference tournaments. They've won their last three conference tournaments the previous three seasons. Last year in the American, their 1 year in that league, they beat Connecticut, which of course went on to win the national championship. And then they won the Big East tournament their last 2 years in that conference. There's a travel. Onowaku picked up the ball near the sideline, took a couple of steps.
What do you think? Coach Pitino has got a little extra motivation this ACC tournament with all the big name coaches he's going up against to get this one in his first year.
I think he's motivated. If you're out playing a $5 Nassau with him, he is an ultimate competitor. Doesn't matter what's at stake. Ooh. Might want to go back to the left hand after that one. Rick Pitino in his 14th year at Louisville. 719 career wins. That is sixth all-time. Coach K, Coach Boeheim, Bob Huggins, Roy Williams, and Bo Ryan ahead of him. Seven Final Fours and a national championship, one each at Kentucky and at Louisville. He's one of the five active college coaches in the Basketball Hall of Fame in Springfield, Mass., and Roy Williams is one of the others. Four of them are in the ACC, Coach K and Jim Boeheim, and the other is Larry Brown. Rozier pulls up. Ooh. And he's hit well after the shot by Britt. First foul on Nate Britt. It'll be three shots at the line for Rozier.
And Nate Britt playing aggressive defense, just a little bit too aggressive. Here draws the foul.
Good free throw shooter at 77%, best on Louisville. Number seven in the ACC, but he missed the first. And he gets there a lot. He can penetrate. He's shot 155 free throws now. Last year, backup when they had Russ Smith.
Free throws are such an important part of Louisville's game. It allows them to set up their full court pressure, which we're so adept at. You talked to Coach Pitino earlier. He hasn't pressed as much this year because of the lack of depth he has on this team. So a much more selectively pressing team this year.
The guards are as good at pressing as they've had in the recent past with guys like Peyton Seaven. Well, that's a walk, or do you put the ball on the end line? I think that was the call when Johnson was trying to keep his balance. He put the ball on the floor to steady himself, and Tim Nestor gestured that he dropped it on the baseline. Well, his foot hit the baseline. More than midway through the half. You add up those three championships in conference tournament play. Louisville's won 10 straight conference tournament games. Blackshear, their leading three-point maker. Harrell on the glass again. He and Onowaku hit the deck. As a result, 4-on-3 the other way for Carolina. Berry drives and lays it in.
Nice aggressive take right to the front of the rim by Berry there.
Wow, explosive to the bucket at the other end, Wayne Blackshear. Togedo out of Menominee Falls, Wisconsin, missed the scoop. Harrell says that rebound is mine.
Some serious rebounds in this game. going down.
7 rebounds already for Harrell. Snyder missed a 3 with nobody underneath for Louisville. Very open for 3. This is 12th 3 of the year. He's 29% for the season from beyond the arc. Here come the Carolina fans with the heels within 4. Rozier's trying to quiet them. Tocado the rebound.
As you can see, every time Carolina gets a defensive rebound, they're pushing the pace, making Louisville get back on defense.
Bryce Johnson faked the shot. Tocado was surprised it was a pass. They got pinballed around off Onowaku to Harrell. Harrell's gesturing to the bench that he needs a breather. Rozier lays it in. Harrell never got across midcourt. Well, and they're going to catch a break. Roy Williams calls a timeout for him. Lost his jacket in disgust. That gets Harrell the breather that he was asking for. DC tournament quarterfinal. And Louisville leading North Carolina 23-17. The winner advances to tomorrow's semis to take on the number one seed, Virginia.
Well, I think that Roy was upset there because no one stopped the ball in transition. He knows Louisville has a tough time scoring in the half court, so every transition bucket they get is like gold for this team.
Berry, another 3. 29% for the year coming in, but he's hit a couple in a row. And they're within one possession as we approach 7 minutes to go in the first half. Mathiang, nice pass. And a blocking foul called as Blackshear went slashing from the wing. Isaiah Hicks stepped in, and he'll be called for his first foul. Gets us to immediate timeout.
Joel Berry getting hot from the outside, knocking out his second 3.
Averages 3.5 points per game, has 8 already today.
Let's go to the studio.
Sean, thank you very much. Studio update, Florida and Alabama just wrapped up. Gators.
Their best player is Montrezl Harrell. He's a junior, but he took part in their senior day activities in their last home game. The anticipation is that this will be it for Montrezl at the University of Louisville. He'll go on to the NBA. Just about did that a year ago. Last April, he sent Rick Pitino a text telling him he was going to head to the NBA. And about 2 hours later, he texted back and said he had changed his mind.
Well, physically, he has the skill set to be an effective power forward. He plays hard. The question is, can he score with his back to the basket on the next level?
Oh, what a bad pass by Joel James. Threw it right to Harrell. Rozier. Tino telling us that everything he does, he patterns after Dwayne Wade, your former teammate with the Miami Heat. All the mannerisms. We've watched him practice a few times. He really does.
Yeah, he does. He does. That's not a bad player to emulate. One of the greatest shooting guards of all time.
Hicks ripped away by Rozier, and then Hicks fouled him trying to get it back. Here's Allison Williams.
During the last timeout, Louisville coaches told Quentin Snyder just to slow down a bit. They're pushing the pace offensively, which they want to do, but they've had some unforced turnovers. Now, that's fine if it happens during the fast break, but when they happen in the half court, that's where they have a concern. So they just talked to him about that during the timeout.
Foul on Hicks is 2nd. They're over the limit. It's a 1-1 for Rozier. Tino wasn't surprised by Rozier's major improvement from a year ago. Obviously, he sees him practice every day, but Terry also had a terrific summer last year traveling around to some of the camps that the players attend. Certainly has the attention of the NBA people as well. Rick says he thinks Rozier down the road could be a lottery pick in time. He has 8 points today. And the lead is 7 for Louisville, matching its largest. Kennedy Meeks missed 3 times. If he wasn't sick before, he is now.
I still like that attack by Carolina. They need to get more paint-centric in their offense.
Rozier waving Blackshear to the other side of the court. Blackshear for 3. He wound up in the right spot. Rozier only became their point guard late in the year after they dismissed Chris Jones, and he's doing a nice job running their team.
He's doing a great job. That's not an easy transition for a scoring guard, but he's run the team very nicely. Nice move by Isaiah Hicks on the point paint for Carolina.
Travel. Harrell angry with Blackshear, and Blackshear pointing at his own chest, saying, my bad. Apparently he wasn't where Harrell thought he was going to be. An eye toward a pass. We have our eye on the Bracketology special. Everything you need to know about the field of 68. Can anyone stop Kentucky? That's one of the big questions that will be discussed Sunday night at 7. Presented by Staples. Live SportsCenter update starting at 5:30 on ESPN. Page lobs it underneath. Hicks had to gather himself. Went back up and dropped it home. On the subject of Bracketology, of course, Joe Lunardi has been evaluating the chances of these two. Right now he has Louisville as a 4 and North Carolina as a 5 seed. Rozier, that's a long 2. Joe told me this morning he thinks that Louisville is a pretty solid 4 and isn't likely to drop with a loss against a team like North Carolina today. Carolina 5 right now, but there is room for them to move up with the opportunity to post some big wins here these 3 days if they can continue on.
The question with Louisville is, will they be able to score enough in the postseason to make a serious run? You know they're going to play great defense. They're going to turn you over. They're going to rebound the basketball. But can they find enough offense?
Justin Jackson kicked the ball out of bounds. It'll belong to Louisville with an 8-point lead when we come back to the Greensboro Coliseum.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Sport begs of you this one simple question. Who will you...
Every year at the ACC tournament, each school has one legend honored. Phil Ford is here. Vinny Del Negro, and congratulations to you, Shane. You are the Duke legend being honored at the banquet here this week.
Well, thank you, Sean. It's a nice way of saying you're old now. But it's a huge honor to be honored for a fun career. A very fulfilling
indeed
career.
Indeed, an honor to place like Duke, North Carolina. So many of these schools with their proud basketball traditions have so many legends to choose from.
Really had a great experience in the ACC. I wanted to play in the best conference in America, and I did that for 4 years, my time at Duke.
Justin Jackson running the floor. Wow, that's impressive. He's 6'8", about 200 pounds, and he went galloping to the front of that break to get North Carolina back within 6. 3 minutes to go in the first half. The winner plays Virginia in tomorrow's first semifinal.
And that's the advantage Carolina has over Louisville, just the team speed in the open court.
Snyder, who's a prolific scorer in high school. Anton Gill, he was too. He hasn't scored much at Louisville yet. And Harrell scores inside. A lot of NBA scouts here. I think every NBA team is represented. And Harrell's putting on a nice show for them.
Well, he's really expanded his game. He's really added his touch around the basket, developed a little jump hook, as you saw there, to help him on the next level.
Kennedy makes his first field goal in 5 tries. A quick counter. Gill took a hard hit. Nice move. He just attacked the bucket. And a sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina, Anton Gill, will shoot a pair. And the foul on Isaiah Hicks is his 3rd.
Louisville giving Carolina a little taste of their own medicine, pushing the pace after a made basket. Nice attack by Gill, earning two free throws.
He's out of Hargrave Military Academy. Gill, he averaged 28 points per game. His last year scored 56 in one game. And has been a deep bench player this year. Just 10 minutes a game, 2.5 points per game, and he struggles from the line, 41%.
We talked about this earlier in the year when we had Louisville. The divide between the top three scorers on the Louisville team and the rest of the team is pretty staggering.
I don't know if I've ever seen that before. The fourth leading scorer on the team has under 4 points per game. Of course, Chris Jones would have given them four players who averaged in double figures for the year. He was dismissed 5 games ago. Nice shot. Bryce Johnson, the turnaround to score over Chinondo Onuwaku. They were down 10, now Carolina within 4. Minute and a half to go till the break. Harrell tried to jam it into Onuwaku, and several of the heels saw it coming. Bryce Johnson got in the way. Johnson had it slide off, and Harrell tapped it out. Snyder out of Ballard High School in Louisville. Scored more than 2,400 points. The all-time leading scorer there. And that's a school at which Allen Houston played and DeJuan Wheat.
Wow. Serious scorers.
Mm-hmm. 45 seconds in the half with 11 to shoot. Grozier fouled. And he'll go to the line. Joel Berry hit him.
That's a skill that he's picked up from Dwayne Wade. Dwayne Wade gets fouled a ton on his jump shots. Terry Rozier is showing the step back behind the back jumper and one. High degree of difficulty makes it look easy.
He has 12 points. He scored 22 or more in 6 of their last 13 games. Averages 17 per game, 4th in the ACC during the regular season.
He had a year that was worthy of a first team selection, but with 15 teams, there were so many great players. Only put 5 on the first team.
And you see, without Jones, only 3 double figure scorers, and the rest of the team, everybody else beyond Rozier, Harrell, and Blackshear, combined for 15 points per game. So if Rozier, Harrell, and Blackshear don't carry the vast majority of the load, they're in trouble. Rick Pitino sends David Levitch into the game, a sophomore walk-on in the final 45 seconds of the half. He's played a bit more lately since the departure of Jones. This tournament, a great celebration of a great basketball conference, but an awful lot of ugly things happening in this league off the court with Jones' dismissal, and he's facing sexual assault charges. Rasheed Suleiman, the same thing at Duke. Syracuse with its probation. North Carolina waiting what the NCAA is going to do for its academic scandal. There's a lot of things that haven't been very pleasant in the conference this year. Thankfully, the basketball is usually terrific. Carry the call against Rozier. Largest deficit was 10 points for North Carolina. Just over 5 minutes to go in the half. Brent had it swatted at the buzzer. Outstanding play by Rozier. Don't have to be tall to block it. He's 6'1", used his quickness to get there and deny North Carolina at the end of the half. Well, Louisville leads by 5, Shane. I'm not sure that's good, though, the way the games have gone with the turnarounds in the second half. 52% from the floor and had a comfortable edge on the glass, Shane Battier.
Well, if I'm Carolina, look, I shot 37%. I'm being out-rebounded. I only have 6 transition points. I'm only down 5. So that's encouraging news. They have a lot of room to grow and play better. Louisville had a great first half. They need to keep doing what they're doing.
Louisville performed well throughout the half in the paint.
Well, Coach Williams was fired up earlier. They were not protecting the paint. Quinton Snyder with a great transition drive. After the turnover right here, Carolina needs to get back. Old transition defense. Someone has to stop the ball. No one does. These are 2 Louisville transition points. And they're very angry. Coach Williams.
Here's Allison Williams.
I noticed during the first half that Roy Williams seemed frustrated with his team's toughness or lack thereof. So I asked him about that. He said Louisville was way more aggressive than us. They were backing us up and out, competing us. He said when somebody comes in, hits you, box you out, you have to do that back. You can't go crying to mom.
Carolina, as you saw, trying to win its first ACC tournament title since 2008. And the last 3 championships in this event have been won by teams from outside the state of North Carolina. Florida State, Miami, and then last year, Virginia. Carolina ball to begin the second half. Justin Jackson, Bryce Johnson all alone there beyond the free throw line. Bad pass. It hit the leg of Chinondo Onuwaku, who wound up with Quentin Snyder.
Those are the turnovers. The drive coach is crazy. It was a terrible angle. Bounce pass was not the right pass right there.
Terry Rozier leads all scorers with 13 points. Montrezl Harrell at 6 points and 8 rebounds in the half. And Louisville turns it over as Jackson got it back for North Carolina.
Need to have a bounce pass clinic after this game.
J.P. Tokoto to Bryce Johnson. Marcus Page for 3. He had a quiet first half. Just 5 points. He was magnificent in their win yesterday against Boston College. 2-point game. Louisville led by 10 in the first half. And another turnover by the Cardinals. Johnson with Page running interference. He just got in the way of Rozier and Rick Pitino. Thought it was a kick ball at the other end that led to the turnover. He's called timeout. He wants an explanation from Tim Nestor.
The big fella, Bryce Johnson, pushing the break, finishes strong. Carolina ties it up.
Bulls Thunder at 1 Eastern. Rockets Clippers at 3:30, Sunday on ABC.
Let's assume you love your money. And
well, Rick Pitino was very upset as we went to break. He thought that was a kick ball, and he's exactly right. Of course it was.
Yeah, that's a pretty good textbook kick ball right there, but they turned it into 2 points on the other end. Like Coach Pitino said in the break, that's a 4-point swing right there.
Some of his assistants got after the officials during the break, and the officials gestured at them to stop talking. They trapped Rozier, who got it out. They trapped Snyder now. He's in trouble. Roy Williams changing up the defense out of the timeout. Blackshear, well short with the elbow jumper. Chance for Carolina to take the lead now. Their last lead was at 5-2, and Johnson will go to the line with a chance to put them on top.
Carolina's come out with a much better demeanor. They were on their heels pretty much the entire first half. They're the aggressor. And that's the reason why they have a chance to take the lead right now.
Wayne Blackshear, the foul for Louisville, his first. Bryce Johnson at the free throw line. 65% for the season for the junior from Orangeburg, South Carolina. He makes both. 9-0 run for North Carolina, dating back to the end of the first half. Their largest deficit was 10. We mentioned several times in the 2 regular season games there were some big turnarounds. Both teams came from double figures behind in the second half to win against each other this year. Blackshear, nice shot from the ACC logo. 12 for Wayne Blackshear. Last year, terrific student as well for Louisville, better than 3.5 GPA in communications. He's guilty of the foul on Johnson, who'll return to the free throw line. In fact, Wayne Blackshear was a second-team academic All-American this year.
Besides being a great student, pretty good basketball player here, too. Spin move into the paint. Tough finish over Justin Jackson.
Matthew is actually whistled for the foul, not Blackshear. And 3-5 is impressive, because we all know how difficult a communications major is.
So you're saying that someone at this table was a communications major?
I was. What was your major?
I was a religion major.
You were?
Yes.
Well, your prayers have been answered. Being here at courtside, working for ESPN.
Have they ever, Sean? Have they ever?
Johnson has the last 6 North Carolina points. Rozier's 3 pops out. Matthew, great job to save it. You're right, Shane. The defensive intensity level for North Carolina has really picked up. I think the half-court trap here that Roy Williams has gone to has helped energize the team. You can't play that defense if you're not active.
No, exactly. And when you have two highly skilled teams, the team that usually is the aggressor and takes it to the other team, the team that usually wins. And that has been the difference here in the second half. Carolina just the much more aggressive team early on.
Last fouls on Joel James. Boy, a big gap in that defense. Harrell there to flush the miss by Rozier. The quick counter by Carolina. Justin Jackson very smooth with the pull-up from about 8 feet. Rozier, 3, and back and forth they go in Greensboro. This is exactly what we expected. Closely contested battle, just like the first two games. Two evenly matched teams. Johnson swatted by Matthew. Snyder powers to the goal, and he'll go to the line.
This is great action. After so many 60-point games we've seen this year, it's refreshing to see teams down the break be aggressive. Montrezl Harrell doing what he does best, follow up jam. The shot goes up, better put a body on him to make you pay.
Brendan Snyder. Boy, a deep bench player when they had Jones. And this is the first free throw. 64% from the line. The first 12 ACC games of the season for Louisville, Snyder scored a total of 17 points. Then they suspended Jones for that ball game up in Syracuse on February 18th. Snyder started and had a career-high 13 points, almost as many as he had in their first 12 conference games combined. The games without Chris Jones, the 5 prior to today's average 9.5 per game. Empty trip at the free throw line, 0-for-2 for Quentin Snyder.
Well, since Quentin Snyder has taken over for Chris Jones, Rick Pitino told me before the game that their defense might not be as good, but their offense is actually a bit better. He feels like there's more ball movement, more side-to-side action. Quentin Snyder does a good job of not keeping it in his hands as much. That's helped him offensively.
And Rozier, as we noted earlier, too, has done a very nice job transitioning largely over to point guard. He takes a handoff from Matthew from 18 feet. Yes. Terry Rozier. What a game he's having. 18 points.
Well, the reason why Louisville is so dangerous is because they have a player in Rozier and Harrell to a lesser extent that can put their team on their backs and lead them. He's that talented.
Beeks fell down as he was trying to back in and set up position in the lane. Snyder, corner 3, short. Marcus Page, the push the other way. Has it back from Tokido. Jackson, 4-3, way off. Ripped out of the air by Rozier. Jalen Johnson on the floor, seldom used freshman. From Ypsilanti, Michigan. Blackshear open, 4-3. Matthew, the tip that would not fall. And Isaiah Hicks got it off to Marcus Page. Boy, Jackson very aggressive here in the second half. Banks one home. Carolina within one. Nearly 5 minutes gone by in the second half.
And that's his strength. He's had a tough year shooting the ball from behind the three, although he's made a few shots last night. He's outstanding taking the ball to the rack.
As Allison said, the ball does move with this group on the floor. Jalen Johnson a miss, but kept it alive. Rozier, the pull-up is long. Mathiang fouled Meeks. Mango Mathiang, the foul. That's his third.
Justin Jackson showing the aggressiveness, semi-transition with a pretty touch. Montrezl Harrell, shot goes up, put a body on him. Bryce Johnson doing what he does best, sending it home. Little emotion.
East Coast Conference had their tournament there, now the Pac-12 there.
We should talk to Swofford about moving it out west. That'd be fun.
Well, John Swofford and the ACC folks are going to move this tournament around the next few years. Next year, it'll be in Washington, D.C. The 2 years after that, Brooklyn, then to Charlotte before it comes back here in 2020. Carolina, chance to reclaim the lead. Down by a point, 14-20 to go in this ACC tournament quarterfinal. The winner will play Virginia tomorrow night. Good post defense by Chinonu Onuwaku. Virginia beat Florida State by 14 earlier today as they try to defend their ACC tournament title. Tonight, Duke and NC State, Notre Dame and Miami. And if Miami's barely out of the field, a win over Notre Dame, you'd have to think would put them in. They signaled for a three for Page, but the officials also gestured that they're going to go back and take a look at that one on the monitor. So for now, it's a three-point goal and a two-point lead for the Tar Heels. Gwen Snyder, Terry Rozier, now Wayne Blackshear, with Onuwaku and Harrell, the starting five on the floor for Rick Pitino. 10 to shoot. And that was a three. Whoa! Harrell Sky tried to tip it in with the left hand off the lob inbound pass. Berry. Offensive foul. Couldn't stop and ran over Wayne Blackshear. Second foul on Joel Berry.
Nice job by Wayne Blackshear getting back, taking the contact. Joel Berry a little out of control on the transition play.
Snyder, wide right, as Johnson came lunging at him. J.P. Tokido, the foul, his fourth. NBA countdown tips at 12:30 on Sunday afternoon. Then the Bulls take on Russell Westbrook and the Thunder, followed by James Harden against Chris Paul and the Clippers at 3:30. That's all Sunday. On ABC, Tokito, outstanding defender to the bench with four fouls. Mike Eads telling Bryce Johnson you can't invade the space there of Snyder. He was jumping around out of bounds. Full shot clock. Snyder into Harrell, working on Meeks. Boy, that looked like a walk. Snyder, blocked by Kennedy Meeks.
Some creative footwork there by Montrezl Harrell. I think he might have gotten away with one.
Seconds to shoot for Louisville. 13 minutes left. Regulation time. They played two classics during the regular season. Boy, Johnson a pretty good bump on Rozier. They play on. This one's shaping up like a good one, too. Rozier short with a three. Louisville should be the fresher team. North Carolina had to play yesterday, defeated Boston College to get here. Louisville had a bye into the quarterfinals as one of the top four seeds. Pass intended for Bryce Johnson. Stolen by Rozier. All the way to the bucket, and Harrell flushed it, but they wave it off as Rozier was fouled on the layup, and he'll shoot two.
Terry Rozier off the turnover. Great hands, great anticipation. One of the best players in the open court. Fantastic finisher, but he's fouled a lot.
Three fouls on Joel Berry. 19 for Rozier. Louisville just 4 for 17 here in the second half.
You alluded to that earlier, Sean. They have a penchant for long offensive droughts. So as good as they've looked in the first half, moving the ball, making shots, they're prone to have some dry spells.
With their first point in 4 minutes, Marcus Page, a long three. Rebounded by Onowaku. Good catch by Snyder on the outlet. Harrell at the rim again. Oh, Snyder put it right on the money. And the acrobatic finish by Montrezl Harrell. Double-double for Harrell. 10 points and 10 rebounds. His 13th of the season to lead the ACC. Bryce Johnson the answer. Each of their regular season meetings had a big comeback in the second half. Today is as tight as it can be in the second half. They're matching each other just about bucket for bucket. 3 second violation. Media timeout.
Well, why are NBA scouts so titillated with the skills of Montrezl Harrell? Here's why. He gets out wide, he runs hard, and he flies high. Sports Center, top 10 nominee right there. UNC, a little taste of their own medicine with 11 fast break points.
Well, they need Rozier, Harrell, and Blackshear to carry the load. Two of the three of them are above their average, and Harrell has a double-double. Johnson fouled at the last minute by Onowaku. Second foul on Chinono Onowaku.
Wow, great look by Justin Jackson down the pipe. Bryce Johnson did a nice job slipping the overplay on the screen, earning 2 free throws.
14 fouls against Louisville in the second half. 5 have been called on North Carolina.
Straight up, everybody, straight.
14 points for Bryce Johnson. He had 17 yesterday to go with 9 rebounds in their win against Boston College. Blackshear, quick catch and release, and a 3-ball for Louisville. They lead with 11 minutes to go.
That was nice ball movement there. Wayne Blackshear did a nice job finding the pocket. Nice clean open look.
15 for Blackshear. The bank open for Bryce Johnson.
He called it. I heard him.
Another good game. He's been criticized locally, occasionally by Roy Williams, for being inconsistent. But he's been consistently good in these two games. Rozier. That looked a lot like Dwayne Wade with the body language as he went down the edge of the lane. Didn't make the shot, though.
All the great scorers have the head fake. Have the head fake, feigning contact.
Back cut by Jackson James right at the rim. Missed the short tip in North Carolina's last to touch. Joel James upset with himself.
Let's go to the back again.
talking about Bryce Johnson. He's had some big performances this year. Double doubles. Tar Heel Nation wishes they could see a little more of that. So when he puts it on and plays at a high level, very few people can compete with him.
He's had 8 double doubles this season. Carolina has struggled against the top teams in the ACC. They're just 1-5 in the regular season against the top 4 seeds. That one win was against Louisville. And a big comeback took place at Chapel Hill. Blackshear missed from the corner.
Great block out by Justin Jackson, battling bigger Mathieu.
Cardinals think Page was the last to touch. That's what Rick Pitino's gesturing. It hit his leg. Was what was Rick Pitino was saying.
We had a good case.
Page underneath. Johnson denied by Mathieu. And this time it is Louisville ball. And Roy Williams doesn't like the call.
There's been some high-level plays above the rim by some serious athletes. Mango Mathieu going up high to catch the ball. Clean block.
His third block of the game. He was born in Sudan, lived in Australia. As a young boy, played rugby and Australian rules football growing up. Mathieu's highlight of the season, we mentioned the game-winning shot in the final seconds. Give them a 59-57 win Saturday in the regular season finale against Virginia. Rick Pitino drew up a play. He said Mathieu was the 64th option on that play, but it wound up in his hands. You can see the clock at the top of the screen. About 3.5 to go when he let it fly. Only shot of the game. Gave them a huge win. He had scored in only 3 of the last 10 games entering today. That was one of them, and his biggest of the year. Snyder's jumper long. Harrell, another rebound. Now Mike Eads, the official, stepping in. Apparently some unpleasantries being exchanged. They did call a foul on Bryce Johnson, his second.
There's been some great lockout battles as the shots have gone up. Again, 2 elite offensive rebounding teams. They know that every possession, every shot, the chance to go get one. And so blocking out, physical, hard blockouts are at a premium this game.
That puts North Carolina over the limit with 8:38 to go. Louisville can call for just 4 team fouls in this half. They're a distance from the bonus. Harrell. Not a great free throw shooter. 58.5%. Dad Samuel in attendance. As he thought Montrez was heading to Virginia Tech, and he was. And then when Seth Greenberg left, Harrell reopened his recruitment, wound up at Louisville. Worked out well for Montrez, obviously, and for the Louisville Cardinals, and it was a big blow to Virginia Tech. One of the best players in the country, who's preseason first team all ACC, wound up at the end of the year on the second team. Snyder called for the foul, a little bit of a mock cheer up from the Tar Heel partisan. Second foul on Quentin Snyder. Do you think Harrell's going to be a good pro?
I do. Look, if I'm a big guy, I will pay for a motor. Montrezl Harrell has a tremendous motor. Look how hard he plays. He goes after every rebound. He's tough. He competes. If you have that and you add it with some physical skills, you'll be a successful NBA player.
Nice passing. And it wound up with Kennedy Meeks. They continue to punch and respond. Johnson got the assist. 9 ties and 10 lead changes. Louisville trying to take the lead back. Anton Gill taken off the floor by Nate Britt. Hey, Goldberry in the mix. Turnaround jumper short. Another rebound for Harrell. The double-double today is his fifth in the last nine games. He has 12 rebounds. He had 20 points, 12 rebounds in the win against Virginia Saturday. He has another dunk. And Louisville goes back on top. Snyder the feed.
What a pass. What a pass. Great court vision. Great seal by Montrezl Harrell right there.
Snyder's given them three assists per game since they lost Jones. Berry, wide left, an air ball. Six assists for Quentin Snyder. He's thrown a couple of beautiful lob passes in this game to Montrezl Harrell. The Cardinals, the one-point lead and the ball when we come back to Greensboro.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by New York Life and the Mazda CX-5.
Pennsylvania, no automatic bids handed out today. This one has been tight for a long time. The last 12 minutes of game action, no more than 3 points separating these two teams. It's a one-point game right now. Louisville's ball and the lead as we tick down to 7 minutes to go. Rozier into the corner. Gill for three. Short. Johnson skied for the rebound. Marcus Page zipped it inside. Bryce Johnson has two more. 18 for Johnson.
Excellent job getting the ball in the middle of the zone, the soft spots in the Louisville zone.
14 of those 18 points here in the second half for Bryce Johnson. Carolina trailed by five at the half. The Tar Heels lead by one. A lot of playing time here for Anton Gill. At crunch time, hasn't scored at all in eight of their last 11 games. Rozier, crowd thought he traveled. Five to shoot. Blackshear down the side of the lane. Shot clock violation.
Seemed to be a little confusion there at the end of the shot clock as to what they were trying to accomplish there.
From here, it might have hit the rim, but apparently it didn't. There's no argument from the Louisville bench, and it was right in front of them. Nate Britt, the sophomore, out there with Paige Tokito, who's playing with four fouls. Johnson and Meeks for North Carolina. ...16 to shoot as they play it back in. Tokido, the pull-up, way short. Matthew came lunging at him. Johnson in the right place. 20 points for Johnson. Early candidate to be on the all-tournament team after what he did yesterday against Boston College. And with this performance today, North Carolina by three, matching the largest lead of the game for the Tar Heels. Rozier for the tie. Harrell lost the battle to Tokido. And then Harrell chased after the ball and committed the foul. His second. Christian Laettner been disliked for so long. ESPN films I Hate Christian Laettner Sunday at 9 on ESPN, presented by Volkswagen TDI. Right after bracketology. Under 5 minutes to go. North Carolina. The ball in a three-point lead. Kennedy makes powers to the goal. Collided with Matthew. A play on. Six unanswered points for North Carolina.
Oh,
of the ball. Powers to the bucket. And through Meeks and Johnson. And the foul is on Kennedy Meeks. His first.
I love the aggressiveness. Montrezl Harrell said, give me the ball. Let me go to work. Great job. Kennedy Meeks showing power as well. A soft touch to boot.
Harrell at the line. Two for two today. Shooting two.
That's what you want out of your best players. Right there, Montrezl Harrell said, hey, we need a bucket. Give me the ball. I'm going to make it happen. You want that attitude out of your best players.
Well, he came back for another year as Britt goes out and Jackson's back in, largely to improve his offensive game. And there's still plenty of room for improvement at the free throw line. He's 58.5 this year. That's up from 46.4 last season. When you get to the line as often as he does, 168 times this year, that's a lot of points left on the free throw line.
That many misses. That is. The great scores. Guys usually lead the league in scoring. Learn that's a great opportunity to boost their numbers.
Only 8 points in the paint in the second half for Louisville. Page has had the knack for making big plays and clutch shots down the stretch, including the game winner in Chapel Hill against Louisville in the final seconds in early January. The fadeaway, short. Bryce Johnson, no. Kennedy Meeks, yes. Eight nothing run for Carolina over the last 3 minutes. No signs of fatigue on the team that played yesterday. Louisville hasn't played since Saturday. Rozier swatted by Meeks.
Carolina making all the plays they need to make right now down the stretch.
They spread the court and run a little time with a 7-point lead, 3:15 to go. Try to keep it in the hands of Page if it gets to a situation where Louisville is going to foul. He's an outstanding free throw shooter. They need a shot now. Jackson, look away pass to Meeks. Johnson out of time. Shot clock violation. Media timeout, 2:57 to go.
Big Ten tournament, look, just about to upset Iowa and Texas A&M right on the bubble, up 10 at the break. Let's go back out to Sean and Shane.
Of course, we have a bubble team in action here tonight. Joe Lunardi has Miami the first team out of the field. Chance for a big resume booster in the last game of the night here against Notre Dame, the number 3 seed, 11th ranked team in the country. A shot clock violation by Carolina, their first turnover in 9.5 minutes. Louisville's gone 4.5 minutes without scoring. And that continues. Blackshear the miss. Out of bounds, last touch by North Carolina.
Carolina has turned the tables with their paint scoring. Now outscoring Louisville 34-28 in the paint.
Whoa, bad inbounding pass by Snyder. Intercepted by Tokido. Johnson. Johnson has been enormous in the second half. He has 16 points, 5 rebounds, and 2 assists since halftime. Page gesturing to his teammates. Let's not be in any hurry. Still 10 to shoot. Louisville desperately needing a stop. Good defense by Blackshear, and it winds up back in his hands after an air ball from Page. Rozier. Honest Mahmoud has come in for the first time. Blackshear, a huge three, and a timeout called by Rick Pitino.
Great push by Terry Rozier. Louisville knows they need to make up possessions, not afford to work the clock. Take the first great available shot. Wayne Blackshear doing a great job reading the defense, finding the pocket. Nice clean look, knocking it down. Only the fourth three-pointer by Louisville tonight. That was maybe the most timely.
Blackshear motivated by Rick Pitino the offseason. Rick said publicly that Blackshear might be the only player he can remember coaching who really didn't improve during his college career. He's improved a lot as a senior. He has 18 points today, but Louisville from beyond the arc, just 4 out of 18 with that make.
Well, he came in highly touted. McDonald's All-American out of Chicago, and for years he's heard from the Louisville faithful that he's not living up to his potential, but I thought he had a nice year, a huge piece of the success of this Cardinal team in his senior year.
2 minutes to go. Full court pressure brought by Louisville. Looking to trap Page, he throws it ahead to Britt. Britt guarded tightly by Snyder. Moving forward to avoid a 5 second count. Roy Williams, a timeout. He still has three more remaining with 1:42 to go and his team ahead by 4, 16 seconds on the shot clock.
Right here we have a clinic on how to attack the 2-3 zone. The soft spot is right in the middle. Bryce Johnson does a nice job sinking into the zone. Nice pass by Marcus Page, beating the zone. The toughest thing to do out of a zone is rebound. Tough to locate a man. Carolina using that to their advantage, picking up the deuce after working hard to get the board.
Rick Pitino said recently that the matchup zone, which has been very good for him in recent years, hasn't been as good without Chris Jones. Hasn't confused the opponents as much as they have in the past since he left the program now 6 games ago.
Well, Jones was their best on-ball defender. He was a guy who could single-handedly take a point guard out of the game, and that's not the strength of Snyder. He's more of an offensively-minded point guard.
10 to shoot, 1:35 left in the game. North Carolina, 4-point lead. They trailed by 10 in the first half. The pass deflected. Good hands by Mathiang. Snyder needs to make a good decision. Rozier, short with a three. Mathiang, the offensive rebound. Underneath, tried to force it into Harrell, and he's lucky he got away with it. Meeks was in between.
Coach Pitino telling the guards, come back and get the ball. We do not need our bigs to be playmakers right now.
J.P. Tokido comes in. Britt goes to the bench. Rozier has missed his last 7 shots, a huge reason why Louisville's gone cold. Their leading scorer struggling. He was shut off there by Tokido. Snyder off the stutter step. Mathiang went in the air too soon. Tokido the rebound, and now do they start to foul? They don't want to foul Page. They do want to foul Tokido if that's what they're choosing to do. Rick Pitino is on the court near center court trying to get his team's attention. Foul that guy. Way too late for that.
They waited a little too long, burned about 15 seconds off the clock. Right now, Louisville needs time. Every second matters.
Two fouls on Rozier. That foul gets them over the limit. So it's a 1-1 for Page. One of the best free throw shooters in the country, 85%. First trip to the line today.
If you're Louisville, you don't need to settle for threes. You can still attack early in the shot clock, get to the rack, maybe get fouled, set your defense up, go for a steal.
Carolina by 6. Snyder launches a three, long rebound, tipped around to Bryce Johnson. Page has it. They didn't foul him. He gave it up. They couldn't foul Jackson. Yes, they did, after he threw it.
And that's the problem with taking a three-point shot. You miss that shot, puts a lot of pressure on your defense to get that extra stop.
Jackson 69.6 for the year. North Carolina's had a good day as a team at the line. 11 out of 13. Anas Mahmoud back in. Mango Mathiang. This is a 1-1 for the freshman Jackson. His first trip to the line today. Louisville's 10-game winning streak in conference tournaments in serious jeopardy now. They won the last three they played in. Last year in the American, 2 years prior in the Big East. They're playing in their third different conference in 3 years. Their first trip to the ACC tournament is not going to be fulfilling. This is the largest lead of the game for North Carolina. Blackshear. Johnson might have tipped it. Page ahead to Johnson and fouled on the way up by Blackshear. Three fouls on Blackshear. Two shots for Johnson, who's our player of the game, brought to you by Cree LED Lighting.
Just a fantastic effort in the second half. After being outscored in the paint in the first half, Carolina came out, they were the aggressor. They went back to their strength of attacking the paint, attacking the boards, getting out in transition. And that was the difference, especially last 5 minutes and in.
16 points in the second half for Johnson. 20.7 rebounds. Now 7 out of 8 from the line as well. He's at 65%+ for the year.
We talked about this yesterday. The record may not indicate, but the numbers and the stat heads love North Carolina for what they're able to do on the glass and offensively.
Well, a lot of talent everywhere you look. 14-3 run. Louisville's gone 7 minutes with only one field goal. Rozier, a desperation heave, makes the rebound. Rick Pitino tells his team no fouls. North Carolina defeats Louisville for the second time in 3 meetings this season. And it's on to the semifinals for Tar Heel Blue. 23-10, Louisville will be 24-8 as they await their seeding and destination on the selection show on Sunday. So it'll be Virginia and North Carolina. They played in Chapel Hill on February 2nd, and Virginia won 70.